Well, I think that it's simple. I think that 15 years ago there were only 2-3 acts that dreamt about this Goa movement and its spirit and music and what it brings to the world. I mean, the message that this music brings of peace, love, unity and respect to mankind. This is something that started, I think, this entire Goa movement 15 years ago, and somewhere 15 years ago, no one, including myself or yourself in Japan, could have foreseen that this scene will get into a state where it hosts 40,000 people in a festival in Brazil or 6,000 people in the SOS festival in Tokyo. These are huge measurements where this scene is now. I mean, if 15 years ago there were only few artists in Israel collecting equipment, starting to sample music and create their own Goa trance, which they've heard in India, or in Goa Gil's ancient and mythological DJ set in Disco Valley in Goa 15 years ago. This was the magic. This is where it started. It came to Israel as something that artists like Astral Projection believe that this is the music that they need to write. It showed them the way. And now I think that 15 years after the beginning, after it started as something small and something that got neglected and banned by the authorities and police and discriminated by the media, these days it's a huge commercial scene, like the house scene, like the techno scene, like the rock and the hip hop. This is a genre that lives now on its own. So this, I think, is the beauty, and in my opinion, there are at least 15 more years of creation, if not more. But then, I will be too old for this.
SOS 2007 was definitely the best one.
The best
one. Comes up in this series of SOS festivals.
It is really, really good venue.
Good venue with 4 days and with the crowd that people only can beg for.
The sound was killer and the people were great. And it was one of the best parties ever, really.
Looking forward to 2008, but really looking forward.
Countries, number one is Japan, because the people are really full on and have a really, really good energies for the dance floor. Number two is South Africa, because of the sort of hippie vibe that's going on there. Number three is Israel, because it's cold. And
this is one of the best vibes.
Yeah.
I hope that it will last as much as it can, you know. It's, for me, it's my biggest wish, you know, to work, to do not the same music maybe. I want to develop, you know, I want the scene to develop. I want to reach like higher points in music. But still, I hope that it will last as much as it can. It already exists for like, for me, I'm working again 13 years. It's a lot of time, you know. When I started doing it, I didn't thought it will last more than 4 or 5 years because it was underground. Today it's more mainstream. The standards are more like close to commercial. Some places are really commercial, so you can say it's a big industry. So you can easily say, you know, if it goes on for 13 years, for sure it has the future is promised for it, you know. I really hope that it will be like this.
Thank you. that was my second SOS, and I can definitely say this was one of the biggest and most massive productions I ever played. Colorful, and if it's production-wise, artists, everything around it, it just was full with everything, good vibes, good people, and for me this SOS was just not a huge party with lots of people, it was much more than it. Big gathering of people from all around the world. And as for me, it's one of the most influential events in the entire scene.
I think that Mother Productions, as opposed to other Japanese organization, has kept throughout the years on a special musical formula. You didn't turn your back to the progressive trance and said no. Opposite, you created a big impressive roster of progressive trance artists, and then you took the best out of the psychedelic artist, but you didn't shift into the psychedelic and forgot your audience, which is, I think, a holy thing, where you grow and grow and grow, but you never forget your audience, the people that are following you, since Mother did parties for 300 people, and now it's 6,000 people. These are still the same people that follow you year after year, and they grow and they grow and they grow. They respect what you guys, as promoters and organizers, are giving them. You're giving them the best music and the best productions. That's it. You keep a special musical formula, and I think that's one of the best things that I ever seen in years, because we know each other, Mother and B&E, for so many years, and you grew up from small events to bring some of the biggest festivals in Japan these days. But still, the music is quality. Quality, and that's my utmost respect to Mother.
parties before in Japan. I haven't been in Japan for 3 years or 2 years. And I think this is one of the best parties I've been in Japan. From everything, yeah, especially the vibe of the people, of the crowd, yeah, the people. It was something really amazing, yeah. Usually when I go to parties to play, I don't enjoy so much for myself, yeah. But this party, I was really enjoy. I drink. I really party. I go to party because the vibe was really perfect. Everything was really nice. The setup, of course, professional Japanese style. Everything there. Yeah. Anything was perfect over there, yeah. Including the lineup. Everything was exactly all right on time. Really enjoyed it. Really.
We'll be right back.
think when people hear Psygraft, they're thinking like it's more intelligent and the good sounds, because we are hearing a lot of other kind of music, not only trance. We hear if it's hip hop, if it's electro, and we take all the influence, not only from the trance scene. So we try to do other stuff also in the production, and we learn from another kind of stuff, music, not only the trance scene. And about the show, it's also like the music. We take, for example, a live rock show. We take, for example, I don't know, Linkin Park or stuff like this. This is our model of how a live should be.
Yeah, our live show need to be like a rock live, because we are a band. We are not only one person with a laptop standing like a DJ. We are more like a band. We want to expand, like maybe drummer, guitarist, maybe vocal one day, but this is our direction.
And also in our live, we are actually playing the live. We are not just putting the laptop to play. We are actually playing the keyboards and playing the guitars and doing sound checks every time. Really do it like a rock band, more than one electronic band.
Japan is number one, after Japan it's Brazil, and then Mexico. And I don't know why, but from the first time we've been in Japan, I feel the vibe from the crowd. I think the reason in Japan, it's not only because of Psycraft, it's the crowd in Japan, very, very good crowd. The people, when they're going out to party, they're really going out and they really invest everything in the party.
They're going to really have a good time, not just come and drink.
Yeah.
So, Japan is the best.
Japan is the best part.
Cape Town's a really beautiful
sunny beachside city, and I think I get a lot of the melody and the happiness and the music comes from living there. Also, the people that live in Cape Town are very, very friendly, very outgoing, like to party a lot, and I think that's the vibe of what I'm trying to do.
Thank you. it's a very good question actually, because many times I've been thinking about if the different conditions where you live influence your music, and I will say that when progressive trance started, and the most progressive trance always came from Scandinavia. So in our scene, it's even have the name of Scandinavian trance, and most of the big artists, not all of them, but a lot of the big artists in progressive trance music all come from Scandinavia. It's Sondkeid, it's Tycon, it's Atmos, it's Phony Orphans, it's Reefer Decree. A lot of the old Scandinavian artists is all from, or the progressive artists is all from Scandinavia. So I've been thinking, why are so many progressive artists in Scandinavia? And I think it's a weather condition. Yeah, I think because in Scandinavia we can have maybe very few outdoor parties every year because of the weather, and so most parties in many years has been indoor in small clubs and basements, underground parties in small locations, and because the fast strong music, like full-on music, is very kind of claustrophobic in small rooms. So when you are indoor in clubs, naturally the more slower and more groover music is more nice. So this is one of the reasons why I think progressive music is bigger in Scandinavia, north of Europe, compared to the rest of the world. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We like your description very much. Psychedelic and universal. It's, we'd like to think we had that element in our music. Technically, I would say on the, for dance floor, System 7 is at a point where progressive and techno and trance meet. We think that's a very nice point to be. We've been there for quite a while now, and that's kind of where we're orientated. But we like to feel that our music can work as a channel for good energies, and we want to make people feel high and uplifted, and we hope that is what happens when people hear our music. Thank you.
Yeah, phew. So keep your mind open for everything. Don't get stuck in anything. Just keep your mind open for music, but for all kinds of energies, and it's all about the groove.
I feel very lucky that my life have led me to become a DJ, and from a DJ to become a label manager, with my work being music. I don't produce music, but I direct it in a way. I say what is good, what is bad. This one will be out and published. This one will be forever in the door. And it's something that I really think is like a dream come true. And I can't wish everybody to run their own label or to be able to make music that will change the world. But all I can say is, it's the slogan of Omega, and it's really how I feel. Music is the soundtrack of our lives. And to be able to work at the music industry, and especially in this electronic slash trance music industry, is like working in Hollywood. It's making movies, it's making dreams come true, it's seeing the world from such a place like Israel to conquer the world and everything. It's the most fulfilling, and I would advise everybody, whatever he can do to be a part of this global thing, to become a dancer, to become an artist, to become a producer, to become, doesn't matter what, my big advice is take part of this, because it's one of the most exciting things going on in the underground dance movement, and it will always stay with us. We need more and more people to come in from every direction. Music producers, again, dancers, labels, promoters, just about anybody. Everybody who feels that is not a part of it yet, run to the nearest place where trance is hot and take part with us in this big global celebration of Israeli trance music. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah.